Hey, what's poppin', everyone? Jake here, and welcome to The Hobby. I'm going to be opening up this Japanese Fusion Strike booster box and giving guys a sneak peek at the final Pokemon card set of 2021. I would like to thank BuyE for sponsoring today's video. BuyE is a shopping service that allows you to buy any product from Japan and ship it to you anywhere in the world. I use BuyE all the time to pick up Japanese Pokemon cards at low prices. You can sign up for BuyE using the link down in the description and get yourself a 2,000 yen coupon on your very first purchase. 2,000 yen is right around $20, give or take, so it's actually a really solid deal. Definitely check them out. Fusion Strike is supposedly our largest Pokemon card set ever, especially in English, so I'm pretty excited to see just what this set delivers. Inside of the Japanese booster box, we're looking for three major big hits. There's others, there's plenty of cool cards inside of this set, but there are three cards I am looking for specifically. I am looking for the alternate art Mew V, I am looking for the alternate art Mew V Max, and I am looking for the full art Alessa. Those are the three big cards that I'm looking for inside of this particular set. There are a ton of other cool cards inside of Fusion Strike. I'm going to give you guys a link down in the description to the Fusion Strike prospective set list. We do not know exactly what Pokemon cards is going to be inside of Fusion Strike, but we have a good idea just so you guys can get a good understanding of what pulls you can expect from this set. Inside of the Japanese Fusion Strike booster box, you are guaranteed yourself at least one single secret rare card inside of your booster box. So I can't wait to see what it's going to be. We're gonna start it off very strong with a brand new VMAX card. And this VMAX card is actually hand-drawn. I think that is super cool. For a lot of the VMAX card, they're CG art, which is computer generated art. No one actually put together the brush strokes. So I think these hand-drawn VMAX cards are a real step up. And I don't think I'm alone in that. When you look at a lot of the V cards and the VMAX card, and you see that the artist is drawn by a studio rather than an actual artist's name, it loses a little bit of its luster to me. I think I much prefer knowing exactly which artist drew some of the Pokemon card art. I think that's just an easy way to build a strong bond, and you can see some of the fresh artists again and again. I still remember a lot of really famous artists when it comes to Pokemon. We have Naoki Saito, Koki Saito, Ken Sugimori, Misuhiro Rita. There's just so many strong names when it comes to art inside of the Japanese scene. There are a couple of American artists and they're very rare, but they do have guest artworks every now and again when it comes to the hobby. And it's sometimes really cool to see some people who do the Pokemon card art, because they can do some pretty zany arts out there. One of the recent Pokemon cards that came out is a Pikachu promo, and it is out of this world. I think it's a super cool promo that you guys have to get a copy of inside of your collection. It's really affordable right now. You can pick one of these up for exactly around 2,000 yen in Japanese, actually. So it's actually really easy to pick up, and it's a solid card long term. It's just adorable. You just cannot find another Pokemon card like it. So that's my little bit of a drop right there. Sometimes people ask me, how do I figure out all these new Japanese promo cards? And a lot of times it's simply because I'm really connected inside of the scene, and I know some of you guys aren't. I mean, like, who has the time to constantly track all the news that is hitting the hobby every single day to understand what drops are going to be happening over the next couple of months? So I do my best to give you guys info on upcoming exclusive promo cards, upcoming drops, any cool boxes, products that are going to be hitting the hobby over the next couple of months, so that you guys can make the decision yourself if you would like to pick up these cards or not. Bolton V Max. I know we had a Bolton V for the longest time, but I don't think we've seen a Bolton V Max yet, so that's pretty cool. I'm excited to see some electric or lightning Pokemon make their way into the hobby. We haven't seen a lightning deck hit the competitive scene in a long time, so perhaps Bolton V will make a strong return. Haven't pulled our secret rare card yet. We are guaranteed one. So far, our hit rate from this booster box is really solid. If you've never opened up a Japanese booster box before, it is an absolute blast, and they are a bit cheaper than the English ones. So inside of the Japanese booster box, you get yourself 30 booster packs. Each booster pack, you only get 5 cards, but I think that's completely fine. I'm not feeling a lack of hits, you know. I'm seeing just about as many pulls as I would get inside of an English booster box. You just get yourself less bulk, and honestly, who really cares about the Japanese bulk cards? You're really just looking for the alternate art, the full art, the VMAX, and all the other cool cards inside of your booster box. You actually can get yourself a Japanese Fusion Strike booster box here in the United States. I'm not so sure about other countries, but you can pick these up directly from Amazon. I will have a link down in the description if you'd like to pick yourself up one of these Fusion Strike booster boxes here in the United States. It's getting a lot easier to pick up products abroad. The exclusive products can still be kind of challenging to pick up. Some Japanese products are only available in the Japanese Pokemon Center, and for those kinds of products, I definitely use services like BuyE. Sometimes the Japanese Pokemon Center will have very simple deals where they say, hey, buy yourself 2,000 yen worth of products from the Japanese Pokemon Center, doesn't even matter what it is, and we will give you this exclusive Pokemon card inside the order. The exclusive Pokemon card is usually worth around 2,000 yen on its own, which is 20 bucks. So I pretty much got my whole entire order for free. I pretty much doubled my value. So sometimes it is absolutely worth it to put in an order directly with the Japanese Pokemon Center. Honestly, it's really the only way you can pick up products. You cannot use an address outside of Japan. If you look at a lot of Japanese products, on the back of them, they actually say not for sale outside of Japan due to legal reasons, international reasons. They cannot sell you Japanese products directly, so you have to go through these third-party services, and they do offer some really cool products. Oh my goodness, there's the Deoxys. This card is super cool because it is a Fusion Strike card, it is a Single Strike card, it is a Rapid Strike card. They literally put every single tag they could on this card, and I think it's hilarious. I actually tweeted it out as soon as I saw this card because it was just so funny. It fits Deoxys' theme so perfectly that I just think it's a hilarious card. I'm glad that it exists, and I can't wait to see what next year has in store, because it looks like we have quite a few cool cards coming out at the end of this year and going into next year. If you think Celebrations was cool, the very next set in Japan is going to be their holiday set, and it's going to contain a lot of shiny Pokemon. I think we're going to be seeing a lot of really cool shiny. Pretty much all the evolutions are probably going to get a shiny VMAX version inside of this upcoming Japanese holiday set, and a shiny Rayquaza VMAX. I think that's going to be the big ticket card of the set. And I don't know if those cards are going to make it to English. We don't have a holiday set this year outside of Celebrations. So if we are going to get these shiny VMAX cards, we might have to wait a whole entire year. So this is going to be an interesting holiday season, because I know a lot of people are picking up Celebrations. Some people are going to be looking out for Fusion Strike, and I'm also looking for the Japanese holiday set. So there's just so much to really look into. All right, let's keep it up. I started off strong, and then I jinxed myself by saying, wow, I was getting all these cool hits, because we have not gone an ultra rare card in quite a while. I'm looking for some V cards, I'm looking for some VMAX cards, and I'm still looking for my secret rare card, which is somewhere in here. Second Arcanine. Haven't seen a single Mew yet, not even a regular Mew or VMAX Mew. I think those cards are actually still pretty solidly valuable. So I'm hoping, fingers crossed, you get yourself one secret rare, but there are so many different potential secret rares inside of that slot. You can get some pretty big duds as well. So if you're a big risk taker, this set is for you, because there are some cards that are worth well over $100. But man, there's some stinkers, and I'm completely fine with it. I understand how pack openings can be, and I do it for the joy of it. And trust me, when you hit yourself that big ticket card, it's an amazing feeling and it's a lot of fun. I would love to see if that card is going to be gem mint. It most likely is. The Japanese sets have really high quality control compared to the English set. It's like night and day. If you look at the back of these cards, you're unlikely to see any whitening whatsoever. I trust the Japanese set so much that I'm very confident that most of these cards are already pretty much perfectly centered. It's just the way they do things. They have much higher quality control than the English set does. This set feels a little bit thick. I have a good feeling about it. I've been so bad at doing that. I don't think I'm actually that good. All right, see, I'm not that good when it comes to feeling how heavy some of these booster packs are. I think the Japanese set technically can be weighed, or maybe it's not possible. There's only 5 cards inside of each booster packs, so if one of these cards is a holo rare, the difference is going to be very, very slight. This is the first set that we are going to see Fusion Strike, and Fusion Strike is not really a thing inside of the actual game. They just kind of made it up so that we have a third strike, pretty much. And I dig it. I think we do need that. I think the Fusion Strike, Single Strike, Rapid Strike style cards have actually been a real hit inside of the TCG. I've been having a lot of fun playing with them. At first, it felt like they weren't going to make a huge difference inside of the TCG, but so far, they are making a strong difference right now. Single Strike has found its stride, so right now, you can play Rapid Strike, and you'll do okay. You can play Rapid Strike or Single Strike, and you'll both do okay. They're both really, really solid, and I'm actually really excited to see how Fusion Strike will do. Ooh, there it is, the Fusion Strike Mew, our first solid card outside of the B-Max. Mew looks okay. I prefer the alternate art version. I think it's much better. And of the two, I think I prefer the regular alternate art over the B-Max alternate art. But I'm not 100% confident in that. I'll have to look at the card in person to really understand if they are as cool as I think they are. We still haven't pulled our secret rare. I'm digging through my booster box. We only have a couple of more booster packs. So here's hoping that secret rare card better be coming soon. Only like 5 or 6 booster packs left. It's in here somewhere. So far, our hits rates have been a little bit low. I would prefer 2 or 3 more ultra rare from this booster box. We've had quite a few dud booster packs in a row. So these last couple of booster packs, I'm expecting to see like some rapid fire hits in a row. So far, that's not happening. Still got a couple more booster packs to go. Man, those are the 3 big hit cards that I'm looking for. Alternate art Mew V, alternate art Mew V Max, and the full art Alessa Strike. I see a little bit of glossy on this one. I think we might have it. And it is, oh no! Oh no, that is probably one of the weakest secret rares that we can pull. Easy come, easy go. Number 103 out of 100, we have ourselves the Full Art Crabominable V. Yeah, so in Japan, the Full Art cards are actually put inside of the Secret Rare slot. I am really against that. I think I would much prefer seeing something else like the Rainbow Rares, the Alternate Arts. I think those make much more sense. I think the Full Art V card should definitely be inside of a lower tier slot, but honestly, that's pretty neat. It is still a secret rare and gonna be a cool card to add to the collection. We also have a very slim chance of pulling ourselves a second secret rare. I heard that it is definitely possible. You get yourself a guaranteed secret rare inside of your booster box, but there's always the slim chance that you get a second one. The first one is guaranteed. You never know, you might get yourself a second one, and we're still looking for a lot of other cards. There is the regular Crabominable V, and it is just laughing at me. That is the CG art that I'm totally against. I much prefer the hand-drawn arts that we're seeing in some of the newer VMAX. So I hope that keeps up. It might just be possible that Chandler is just like super difficult to draw inside of a CG art style, so they just had to hand draw it. That might be what they had to actually do. There's the regular Alessa. Why can't I find you in the full art version? Well, I always have the chance to look at her inside of the regular English booster box. Those are going to be a lot of fun as well. There's going to be a lot of cool alternate art cards and hopefully some really cool full art trainer cards. Looks like we got ourselves a regular holo rare inside of this booster packs. Our second holo rare Steelix. I already pulled one of those earlier in this video. Didn't really talk about it, but I saw it coming. A little bit low on the hit, I would say. 7 hits so far. Can we get a final hit inside of our last booster pack? If not, then I would say this booster box was a little bit lackluster. However, I have a couple more of these Fusion Strike booster boxes, so hopefully we can get some cooler cards in some upcoming pack openings if we continue to crack these open. Final booster packs, nothing too crazy. So this is new, but this is actually really cool. If I look at the Mew, Mew's actually raised. There's actually some serious texturing going on with this ultra rare card. It is not flat. There are some serious bumps and ridges along the Mew, specifically on the Pokemon itself, as well as some texturing around some other places on the cards, like right along the V rule here on the bottom. So there's some interesting things that they're doing that are really designed to be anti-fake cards. So this is one of the mechanics that you can actually use to see if your cards are real or not, is with the new texturing. I think that's pretty cool. I hope we see something similar inside of the English production line, because the regular V cards can actually be faked really easily, since a lot of the V cards have zero texturing at all and are just laminated cards. It's very easy to fake them. The VMAX cards, the full art trainer cards, the rainbow rare cards have super unique textures and it's impossible to fake them. But for some of the regular ultra rares, it's still very easy to fake. That's why there's not a lot of value there. But I think it's cool that they're doing these little things, and it's going to be nice so that you can easily recognize when you get yourself a fake card. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys next time.